Hello, this is Dave Smithy with Top Out Adventures. Thanks for tuning in today. Today we're going to have an interview with Aaron Zel. He is our sponsored athlete. We spoke to him about a month and a half ago as he was getting preparations for the Rocky Racoon 100. We're going to check in with him today to see how all of his training's been going and where his head is at here with about a week and a half to go before the race. Thanks. Hope you enjoy the interview.
Hey, Aaron. Good morning. Thanks for joining us today. How are you doing today?
I'm good. Thanks for setting this up.
Absolutely. Thanks for being a sponsored athlete for us here on Top Out Adventures. And we're anxious to hear how your training for the Rocky Racoon has been going and how you're feeling. It's what, how many days do we have left yet?
I think tomorrow is 10 days if I'm doing my math right. So it's coming down.
It is coming down into it. Have you hit the sweet taper section yet?
I have, yeah. So I kind of started it last week. So it's nice. Today is supposed to be my really long run, which is supposed to be 90 minutes, which comparatively 2 weeks ago, I had my long run was an 8 hour run. So it's definitely tapered off in that regard.
All right. Well, you've earned it. So enjoy it. Enjoy those runs. Let everything heal up and get ready. So, so we talked to you, about 6 weeks ago, 6-8 weeks ago, and you were, I think you were about to get into the heaviest part of your training. And based on what you shared, you've done some heavy stuff, but how's it been going? What kind of mileage you've been doing and particularly like what type of mileage, how's your training been going?
Yeah. So I have experience with running in the night. I mean, the plan with this race is obviously going to be, you're looking at probably 20, 22 hours, 24 hours. I'm not sure exactly where I'm going to fall in that spectrum, but if I start 6:30 in the morning, I'm definitely going to be running throughout the night. So one of the things that my coach had me do was wake up at 1:30 in the morning and leave the house at 2 a.m. and run for 4 or 5 hours. So it was a really weird experience of running in the city, literally throughout the night. It was kind of nice watching the sun come up, and most runners were out then at that point. And it was like, yeah, I've been running for 4 or 5 hours at this point.
Yeah.
It was cool. I mean, it was cool, but it was really weird at the same time. So one of those runs was kind of smooth sailing. The other one was much more difficult. We had I wouldn't say a snowstorm, but we had a snow that ended at like 1 o'clock in the morning, and I started at 2 o'clock in the morning. So that entire run, I was running on like 2 to 3 inches of snow during that period. Wow. And, you think snow, that's soft and easy. And it feels like running on sand. So in my mind, it was like running on sand for 5 hours. And it was hard. I mean, my legs were really kind of done in at the end of it. I mean, I really think that like out of all the workouts that I've done, that was probably one of the harder ones. But I'm really glad that I did that. I mean, it wasn't just like running for 4 hours. It was running for 4 or 5 hours when you're really, really tired. I mean, I went to bed at like 6, but I probably didn't fall asleep until like 8 or something like that. Right. So, I mean, I did get some Z's in there, but the point of it was to run when you were kind of, I wouldn't say fatigued, but definitely tired at the same time. So that was those, I did two of those runs, running and waking up at 1:30 in the morning and running throughout the night. And then the other really crazy one was an 8 hour run. And the 8 hour run was the day after a 2 hour run. So it was, you were kind of running 8 hours, but running kind of, I wouldn't say again, fatigue, but like your legs were kind of tired from the run from the day before. So that I basically ran almost all the way around St. Paul and Minneapolis. The kind of plan was to just make it all the way home. And if I did that, it would have been 54 miles, but at 6.5 hours into the run, I was kind of averaging like a 9 minute pace, but at like 6.5 hours in, I got to, I think like 11, 12 minute miles at that point. I was just, I was done.
Mm-hmm.
And so I called Kevin, my husband, and I said, hey, I know I'm only like 3 miles from the house at this point, but
okay.
you gotta pick me up. Like, I am
uh-huh.
absolutely done.
Yep.
So it was good. I mean, my legs were really, really tired the next day, but it was good practice. I mean, that is 49 miles is, you know, basically, you know, halfway. So it's,
yep.
I know I got to double that. And in my mind of thinking of like, sure. wow, doing that, I have to do that. Like not once, but twice. It's kind mm-hmm. of, it puts it all into perspective, but, yeah, overall, I mean, my peak week, I got up to 73 miles. I think it was, if I'm looking at the math right,
mm-hmm.
looking at Strava, it says my peak week was 73.76 miles with 11 and a half hours of running. So that's
yeah.
where I'm at with the training. I'm just tapering right now. I'm a little sore. I got my knee is kind of, I think it's more my hamstrings that are giving my knee some issues. So I'm going to go get a professional massage today to just try and work out the tension in the hamstrings. But
mm-hmm.
besides that, I think I'm ready to go. I mean, I feel ready.
Yeah. Yeah. You sound like it. I mean, you've put in the work. So, clearly, you know, so you're ready to go. We're going to make it happen for you for sure. So,
yeah.
So you said you used a coach and, I think you've done that on and off, if I understand yeah. correctly, kind of through your career. So, I'm sure your coach is great. So not any comment on your coach, but on
yeah.
in the kind of the general, the role of a coach. Yeah.
yeah.
I'm sure it's been helpful. Is it something you want to keep doing? You take a break. What's your thoughts now having used a coach for this big race?
Yeah. So I've used him probably for the last 3 or 4 years, I can't remember exactly. I mean, a lot of it was to just really ramp up my speed. And then
mm-hmm.
about 2 years ago, I kind of came to the conclusion that my times weren't going to get faster. And so I just wanted to kind of move on to distance at that point. And I think it's been really helpful because I don't know how to train for these really longer distance things. And that's something that's
right.
been helpful for somebody that has a lot of experience with doing ultra marathons and winning, you know, some 100-mile races is he knows mm-hmm. how to train for it. And so I would definitely recommend it because for me, it's been helpful to kind of know what to train for. And so
mm-hmm.
it's, yeah, I think that's just, I mean, I guess that's all I got to say. It's been really helpful because I don't know what to train for.
Yeah. Yeah. The times I've used a coach, it just, there's a certain confidence, you know, there's obviously a lot of, in education that comes with it. And then there's just the confidence knowing what I'm doing is the right stuff. So I've always found that really valuable. So do you want to step out on any limbs and, give any expectations for your Rocky Raccoon 100?
Oh, it's so hard to make that prediction. I mean, I guess I just said it, but so yeah, I mean, when I did the 49 miles, it took me 8 hours and 7 minutes or 8 minutes, something like that. Again, you mm-hmm. don't, I'm not going to double that. It's not going to be 16 and a half hours for me to do the 100, but I think it is realistic that I could come in between around 20 hours. I'd like, obviously like to be
okay.
on the other side of the fence on the 19 and change side.
Sure.
But I mean, I think it's more realistic to set my expectations of between 20 and 22 hours. I know
yep.
from what everybody says, it's that last little push that really, really gets to you.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't, you know, it's just running on being fatigued and,
mm-hmm.
that last 20 to 30 miles is not going to be like the first 20 to 30 miles. So I know that I'm well aware of that. And I that's where I'm going to need some help getting me across the finish line in that regard. But that's my goal. I'd really love to come in around the 20 hour mark.
All right. Well, yeah, I'm going to be out there pacing you there at the end. So we will definitely, be looking at it and doing everything we can. And, I mean, you put the work in, so, you know, it'll take, it always, obviously, you hit your goals, your A goals, it takes a little bit of I don't want to say luck, weather and all that coming together, but everything, you've done all your part. So it looks like the rest is going to come together. We're going to make it happen for you. So we really appreciate you sharing your thoughts and your experiences getting ready for this race. Looking forward to connecting with you again next, week and a half. Looking forward to that and seeing everybody else out there. Thanks for everything you shared, and look forward to seeing you and everybody else at the Rocky Racoon here in just a week and a half. All right. Thanks. Take care, Aaron.
Awesome. Thanks so much.
Four,